Okay, hello everybody and welcome back to WEC. Just gotta make sure one little setting is right and looks like we are all good to go. So welcome back, of course, to WEC. This is now the LAN finals being hosted over in China. We had some images of the big stage that's been set up. It looks fantastic. I really wish I could be there in person, but alas, just casting it from home here in Australia. And I gotta make sure that I unmute the in-game audio as well, guys. Just give me a second to handle that. Okay, now everybody should have some in-game audio. We should be sorted out. Now I should have audio in the game as well. So I'm Basekip. I'm here providing coverage on behalf of Join Dota so that Cap can get a little bit of a rest since he's been doing late shifts and so that he doesn't have to do 24 hours worth of Dota coverage in a single day. So it's great to be here joining you guys for this match. We've got a bunch of great Dota going on today. For the first two rounds, there are going to be two concurrent matches played. So we've got HUT versus Newbie over here on Join Dota Blue. And we've also got EG versus Vici Gaming, which should be starting up over on Join Dota Red. And that's going to be Toby and Clairvoyant. So if you guys want to go and welcome the return of Fear or check out any of your favorite Vici Gaming or EG players, then I encourage you to either jump over to that stream or bring up a multi-twitch, bring up a second tab, do whatever it's going to take to get you guys to digest all of the great Dota that we've got going on today. Of course, your other option is to check out this game in the client. A warning though, since these games are being hosted on Perfect World, your in-game audio may be a little bit choppy. So keep that in mind before you make the plunge and buy the ticket. Think about your enjoyment of previous Chinese tournaments and weigh up whether it's right or not for you. It is a $5 ticket for anybody who's interested. And I think there's also iLeague coming up before too long. So if you want to be picking up some tickets for some in-game great LAN coverage, then that's a great steal as well. But I think that's pretty much it as far as introductions go, guys. Let's get ourselves underway with the draft this game. Newbie going to be over on the Radiant, banning out a Razor and a Faceless Void. HGT not having the benefit of first pick, being over on the Dire. They are going to be banning out a Death Prophet and a Lycan. Shadow Shaman is immediately snagged by Newbie, and HGT, the follow-up, is going to be Doom and Bat. More than likely going to be the Doom for ZSMJ, I would guess, just based on recent trends from the team, but we will have to keep an eye on how things develop. As we were talking about in the chat just a little bit earlier, guys, I think Newbie definitely coming in as the favorites for this match. Very strong performance at TI. They have, of course, lost Xiaowei, so the captain, drafter, and mastermind behind the team has left them, but Banana stepped up to take the reins. They have looked a little bit shaky at some stages in the game, but they've been doing fairly well. So we'll see how they go. They've had some pretty good performances recently, mainly against Tongfu and LGD, though they did end up dropping a very important best of one to LGD CDEC, which was iLeague qualifiers. So for anybody who is watching that, I think LGD CDEC actually just walked all over them in that match. But anyway, or might be thinking of the wrong match. I am maybe a little bit befuddled. Anyway, Newbie just going to be picking themselves up a Brewmaster here. We've got a Whimper from Skywrath Mage as he does get banned out here. Newbie just trying to protect their Brewmaster a little bit. There is already a Doom and a Bat. Brewmaster can sometimes survive through a Lasso, I would say. You can also potentially survive through a Doom if you've got the correct counter initiation, but we'll have to see. And I'd be interested to see if Sancheng is, if they're going to be picking up Earthshaker for Sancheng. They've been playing it pretty heavily against Doom. It's not a terrible way at all if you're very good with Fisher to disengage from a teamfight after Doom has been expended. Also, not bad long-range counter initiation against the Batrider either. And Sancheng's had a lot of performances on the hero this past month, and I think he's maintained something like an 83% win rate on his Earthshaker. So Newbies, I would not be too surprised to see that coming out from Newbie here. Though again, we'll just have to keep an eye on how the draft develops. Another big signature hero for Newbie just going to be banned out here by HGT, as Banana's Enchantress is going to fall a little bit by the wayside. HGT may be a little bit worried about a super 5-man strategy out of Newbie. They do have the Doom for some good teamfight power. That's always nice. But Batrider's strength can be a touch diminished against a five-man lineup, where it's very difficult to hit for him with only a Blink Dagger and no Force Staff to be able to get in, drag somebody away a relevant distance, and get out. If you jump in, you get a lasso off, but you get bursted down in the middle of the enemy team, well, then your initiation wasn't really worth anything. And that can definitely happen if the enemy team is really five-manning and gets the ball rolling. Though, Batrider on the Dire side, always going to be powerful. You've got that Roshan protection heading in towards the mid to late game. And a team cannot five-man 24/7. If you have one hero that can apply any kind of split push pressure, you will eventually force them to split up. They'll split up, they'll go and do a little bit of farming, and that's where the Batrider can find his pickoff and keep on going. And HUT is still just very wary of that five-man strat, going to be banning out a potential mech carrier for a newbie, since they don't actually have a viable mech carrier at the moment. You definitely do not want mech on Brewmaster, and Shadow Shaman is very unlikely to buy it either. If he gets that level of gold, he's more than likely going to be heading into a Blink Dagger, a Force Staff, and an Aghanim Scepter, or some combination of the above.
5 seconds
and
remaining.
Newbie, I think, wisely are going to ban out the Centaur here. So more Newbies than likely, actually, I'm not 100% sure what HUT are going to be doing. I do think it's going to be the ZSMJ safe lane Doom. I don't know what they've been doing with the Batrider recently. I don't know if it's going to be run mid. But they did pick up an Earthshaker here, so the potential for some block shenanigans in the offlane. You can't, of course, pull things into Ancients anymore, but you can still bring the lane all the way back underneath the tower and secure some good experience for your offlaner. And I think a really heads-up pick from HUT as well. We were just talking about how successful Sancheng has been on the hero, that it is nice to have against the Batrider and the Doom. So not only does it give them a lot of strength in counter-initiating, canceling shackles, things like that, it also denies it away from newbie, which is definitely always nice. But and also it gives them a little bit more defensive power as well if newbie are going to be going for this very heavy five-man oriented kind of pushing strategies. So I think a very nice pick overall. Newbie heading into this next round, still plenty of reserve time left. And just give me a sec, guys. Apparently Mott managed to so we loaded, it failed, and then we all got booted out before even all of the spectators actually loaded. So we all got booted out to the lobby, and me and Mott were like, what the heck just happened? And then I think Mott somehow managed to leave the lobby. So that's the discussion that's going on right now. I'm getting some PMs asking, is the game going to be remade? I don't think so. So there you go.
10 seconds remaining.
Meanwhile, what have we got? Newbie are going to pick themselves up an Invoker.
5 seconds remaining. So,
more than likely going to be your Quaz Exort Necrobook Invoker
Newbies
this game, I would
pick.
Suspect. Yules could also be a very nice pickup. It's pretty good against Bat. If you've got fast fingers, the second that he jumps in, you Yules him, you can prepare for some follow-up stuns and some nice counter-initiation. Even if he gets the lasso off as well, Yules can be a fantastic way to waste a lot of the duration on the lasso. So maybe we'll be seeing something like a Yules, but it does come down to player preference a lot.
10 seconds remaining.
As far as Invoker builds go at the moment. Could even potentially be
Five
a Quaz-Wex
seconds remaining.
Invoker. We'll have to keep an eye on things. That is, again, also going to be a personal preference thing, whether or not
Dire
maybe think that they need a little bit more to carry them through the late game and a little bit more tower damage. In which case, Quaz Exord, if they feel that they can just teamfight their way through this game with Brewmaster and a Quaz-Wex Invoker, then we could definitely see that from them as well. But Ancient Apparition going to be the pick for HGT, so maybe even a potential aggressive tri-lane coming newbies' way. The Lich is going to help with that, or help in mitigating
Reserve
that
time.
A little bit, but still not amazing. I think the Invoker is even maybe more of a deterrent for the HGT aggressive tri-lane than potentially the Lich. And also, newbies still have some pretty good offlane options that would be able to 1v1 the Doom pretty well. Something like a Timbersaw is still definitely not bad here. There's plenty of squishies over on HGT, and if you're Dooming the Timbersaw, then you're going to get messed up by the Brewmaster and the Invoker. So HGT are going to have to tread pretty carefully if they're looking towards an aggressive tri-lane here. Not that the aggressive tri-lane would by default be a bad idea, There's just a lot to weigh against it. You're going to be giving farm to the Invoker. There's potential Sunstrikes coming in. Newbies, there's a Lich down there. You're on the Dire side, so you can't necessarily lock the Radiant team out as much as you'd like. And if newbie think that HCT are going to go aggressive, then they can just roam the Shadow Shaman, put the Lich in the offlane, and sack somebody to the safe lane as well. So, I don't know. Maybe not going to be seeing aggro out of HCT for all those reasons and more. And meanwhile, just going to have Weaver banned out by HGT, thinking that newbie are going to be looking for a little bit more late game power in the midst of all of this. And newbie will be getting rid of, I think importantly, getting rid of that split push factor. So we were just talking about earlier how if newbie can get the 5-man death ball rolling, then it's, if you have any semblance of split push, you can eventually force them to break up a little bit, and that's where you can start getting some pickoffs with the Batrider. But if newbie get the death ball going and HCT don't have any semblance of split push at all, then we could end up with a lot of stalemates. So we'll have to see.
Newbies, turn to pick.
But okay, HCT, pick up the Templar Assassin. Pretty nice hero to have against the Invoker. Not all that amazing against the Brewmaster. Can take a very long time to build up an MKB. Does offer a little bit of split push, gives them some Roshan power that they were lacking given that they are a Dire side. I mean, they've got the protection aspect in the Batrider, but they didn't really have anybody to help bring it down quickly. So
reserve time.
The Templar Assassin's definitely nice for that one. And I'm just going to accept a friend's invite so that he can use my tournament ticket to watch WEC, because not everybody has a million tournament tickets like I do. And finally, newbie with 20 seconds remaining are going to pick up likely... there's plenty of options here, actually. Brewmaster or Invoker could potentially be mid or safe lane. Brewmaster could also potentially be off lane with the Lich, so they've got space for a safe laner if they want it. They've got space for an off laner if they want it. And newbie are going to wrap things up with a Slark. So another hero that if he doesn't get doomed is going to absolutely wreak havoc here. Oh, I'm going to turn off my Netgraph for you guys. Sorry about that. It's just up the top, but I know it can be a little bit distracting for some people. So there we go. Got that sorted out. I think we are now pretty much 100% ready to go. Slark also, of course, nice for being able to strip off Refraction pretty quickly. The Earthshaker and the Ancient Apparition are reasonably straightforward pickoffs as well. Also quite nice to have against the Bat. If you have Fast Fingers, you can potentially dispel the Lasso. And that's always going to be important for IC to keep in mind in terms of who he's looking to initiate. The Lich is maybe a little bit of a weak pick this game, but we'll see. Maybe it'll get newbie enough of an advantage out of the lanes, or maybe it'll set up the offlane Brewmaster or Slark well enough that they should be okay. So, and also, I'm not a huge fan of Lich in general, so maybe there's a little bit of bias coming out of that as well. But guys, welcome into the game. It's WEC LAN Finals upper bracket round one. We've got newbie versus HGT over here, and we've got Vici Gaming versus EG over on Join Dota Red with Toby and Clairvoyance. But for those of you who are joining me here, let's introduce our two teams. Over on HGT, we have Pretty Haw on Earthshakers. ZSMJ is, as expected, going to be on Doom. I don't know why my hero centering is off, but I guess I just won't be using it in this game. Perhaps a bug that was added in the new patch. We've got Kaka on the Templar Assassin. S, or CYS, is going to be on Ancient Apparition. And over on the Batrider, we have Icy. Meanwhile, for newbie, we've got Hal heading towards the offlane for the moment. As Slark, we've got Banana, who's going to be handling that Lich. Rabbit heading towards mid as Brewmaster. Very quick Bottle Rush primed for him. Moo's going to be handling the safe lane on Invoker. Always excited to be watching this guy play absolutely anything. Moo is, I think, one of the shining stars of TI. And finally, over on newbie, we have Sancheng on the Shadow Shaman. Boots first, picked up, ready to try and get some roaming around. This Dire Observer Ward that was placed a little bit earlier did spot him placing his obs somewhere in this region. Got pinged out by HGT, so we might see that one dewarded before too long. Pretty Haw has made his way down. He's actually got a sentry ward at the moment, and no big surprises. He is going to be blocking off the lane to start things off, just to make sure that it pulls up underneath the tower and secures his Batrider, his pretty much all-important level 2. So, pretty heads-up plays coming out of HGT to start. And Pretty Hall, looks like he's even going to go for a second block here. Maybe? No, okay, just going to leave it through. Rabbit, interestingly enough, picks up an early point in Clap. The TA, if she doesn't get good side blades down, can't necessarily contest you in pushing out the lane, and that can mean that you can secure a few more runes and bring the lane back to even. The alternative way to play this lane is to get a super early point in Drunken Haze, Bottle Crow nonstop, and just spam Haze on the TA to interrupt her farm as much as possible. So we'll see which option Rabbit ends up going for at the moment. He is playing pretty aggressively to set things up, and as I'm saying that, I'm missing first blood up on top lane. Not defensive enough out of the Slark. Looks like maybe got netted down by the Doom, and with Chilling Touch, that's going to be enough for the duo lane to pick up a kill. Some illusions going out as well. My bad, guys. Missing the first blood. Meanwhile, bottom lane move 5 stacked up will be brought down as well by Icy, and HGT rocketing out to a 2-0 lead. Just honestly, a little bit of sloppy play from newbie. Mu letting himself getting stacked up like that. And now Rabbit, the only one who is having about as expected a time. Almost having the kind of time that you would expect in his lane. So, okay, gotta get my head in the game here, guys. So apologies for that, but we should be fine from here. Anyway, Mu comes back bottom lane, immediately gets 3 stacked again. Does manage to dodge the 4th stack, however. Nope, not quite. Sunshine's actually very low on mana, so Icy's just gonna come straight back in again. He has, however, aggroed the tower a little bit. Still coming in, 5 stacks on Mu, 6 stacks on Mu, right click, finishes him off. Looks like Icy is gonna lose his life, but a beautiful Fissure comes out of the trees. And can they actually close the gap? There's already boots in this Batrider. He may try and just suicide to the tower, not give experience away to the supports. Not gonna happen, they were still close enough. But HGT. Well, actually, Mu, I was just hyping this guy up, the shining star of TI, but that is absolutely back-to-back deaths on the Invoker with nothing to show for it whatsoever. Also, a kind of greedy build going for the Quasi-Exort. No Invoke by level 2, so no Cold Snap, nothing to punish the dives. Sunshine already used up all of his mana just harassing with Aether Shock at the start of the game, but Batrider manages to find the opportunities, and HGT rocketing out to an early lead. In terms of overall farm, TA doing very, very well on mid, as is Rabbit, who's already got his bottle shipped out. Looks like we aren't going to be seeing the early point in Haze build this game. Just a very standard 2 points Thunderclap and point Drunken Brawler at this point, but is getting up in the face of the TA quite a bit. Oh, for anybody, I guess one thing I haven't talked about, so let's talk about the stakes of this match. It's a best of three. The overall prize pool for the tournament is about 170,000 USD, or the equivalent in RMB. And this is our upper bracket round one, so it's just a full double elimination 8-team tournament. Loser is going to drop down to the lower bracket. Winner is going to advance to the upper bracket semis, which are actually going to be played today as well. So lots and lots of Dota coming up today. I think a grand total of 6 best of threes, four of which are going to be concurrent with one another. So sort of 4 total best of three time slots overall. But anyway, that's just the context for anybody wondering about any of that. 4-minute rune's gonna be spawning up down on the bottom, so Pretty Haw already in position to camp that one out. A very respectable level 3 already up on this Earthshaker. Icy already with some Tranquil Boots making his way back down bottom lane again as the stacks continue to climb on Mu. He is a little bit safer now with his Cold Snap and his Sunstrike at the ready, but Batrider finding those opportunities in the early game. Slark getting lots of farm on the offlane courtesy of this Lich. So nice to see at least the Lich pick is paying off a little bit for a newbie here. And both teams falling into a slightly more defensive posture now. Just a little bit of farming going on. Mu tries to cancel the Clarity with Cold Snap, but new Cold Snap is not enough damage to dispel consumables until you actually get 4 points in Quas. So a little bit of a wasted snap there from Mu. And showing maybe that he's not No, maybe not feeling super comfortable on the invoker so far this game, though. We'll see. He'll probably find his rhythm a little bit further in. Nice defensive posturing out of San Sheng. Fisher wildly off the mark by Pretty Haw is gonna leave him just fine to wander away, but heads up play from him just to be sitting off to the side like that and anticipating the potential rotation across, especially given that his observer ward did get dewarded by the sentry that Pretty Haw was carrying. So they don't have full information as to what's going on in the lane. That's just it's just good map awareness overall. Well, good game sense, rather. And meanwhile, Banana's going to be heading over to mid, but just getting spotted out by the vision of this TA trap, it would seem. So it gets pinged out a little bit. Yeah, just going to get rid of the trap there. It is nighttime, so Kaka couldn't actually see over to the opposite cliff, but nice trap placement is going to keep him safe and makes the support rotation a little bit of a waste of time. And meanwhile, Hao, left to his own devices on top. Looks like he's going to be okay, though. Could swap his treads to get a tiny bit more out of this salve, but it doesn't really matter. He's just trying to bridge the gap to level 6 as safely as possible. And 6-minute rune, well, some contest going on for it on towards top lane. Hao going in, manages to get the dispel off, but pounce a bit off the mark on ZSMJ, who charges in. But no level 6 for him either, so looks like not going to be a kill in either direction. 6-minute rune is down bot. Rabbit's going to snag that one and go back to spamming Thunderclap over at mid. Actually opting to pick up a second point in Drunken Brawler as opposed to getting the point in Haze, which actually surprises me just a little bit. The second point in Brawler is Radiant's not that impressive. Picking up the first point is definitely compulsory because it's basically Janata, free last hit, so how? Fisher into Doom up on top lane. Maybe gonna be enough damage. There is a TP coming in, but it does get cancelled. So it looks like he may just tick out here. Yeah, he will. That's very, very sad for now. And meanwhile, rotation coming in mid. There's the Shackle, Sunspike as well with the clap. Cleans up the kill on the Templar Assassin, so... Well, newbie, at the very least, do manage to find a little bit of a trade somewhere else on the map. Kill does end up going to the Shadow Shaman as well, so... Sunshine, 7-minute Arcane Boots, very, very respectable for him. The Rasta's always going to get a little bit of extra farm when he's teaming up with somebody like a Lich who can do all of the warding and not really fall behind. So we might even see a very farmed Sancheng this game. And like I was talking about, he's been making big plays on Earthshaker and his other supports recently. So looking forward to seeing what he can do with a little bit of additional farm. Mu not really showing off what his build is going to be too much just yet. Just some early phase boots for the time being. Suspects that the Batriders roving in from the side since, well, doesn't suspect it, knows it because of this observer ward. And he's going to be just fine, so. A slightly unsuccessful rotation from Icy, but he was just coming down here for the farm, really, anyway. I guess the one big difference between the kill top and the kill on mid was that newbie weren't forced to invest the primal split, so that should, in theory, be another potential kill coming up at some point, assuming that they can get this Brewmaster away from mid surreptitiously, but he's going to have his Blink Dagger up in just a second, so they might even just pick up another kill on the TA here. There's the Hex going out, the slow, they need to chew through these Refraction Charges as fast as possible. The clap goes out, but there's still enough Refraction to soak the Sunstrike and the clap, so TA is going to be fine. Rabbit coming in with the double damage, does end up using his guaranteed crit though, so... Looks like not going to pick up that kill. How even TPing in towards mid, so... Really hoping to force something here. They do have the Blink Dagger on the Brewmaster being shipped out right this second, so maybe a bit of an opportunity to force things, but Pretty Haw hiding over in the trees, ready to close the door if anything gets too crazy over on middle lane, though. Hao still playing up pretty aggressively. And meanwhile, top lane, S just getting an opportunity to farm up his level 6. That early first blood actually doing a lot for him, and looks like no interruption on any of his pulls or anything like that. The Doom also opting to head into the jungle for a little bit and leave the Ancient Apparition in the lane. So, really nice decision from HGT, just really efficient and secures this level 6 very, very early on. I also like the skill build quite a bit coming out of S this game. There's quite a bit of magical damage on the team between the Earthshaker and the Batrider, notably. So, having the extra Ice Vortex, I think, is definitely going to be worth it in this instance. And they don't have that many amazing ways to proc a cold feet. I mean, they can lasso somebody into a cold feet, for example, but if you need that much lockdown on a single target, well, you may as well just go for the extra burst damage. Newbie, three-man smoked up, so we've got S hiding in the trees over on top lane. They're gonna be really wanting to get some value out of this primal split if they can, but Doom has already cooled down over onto this MJ. Just gonna be a Hand of Midas build out of him, so yeah, keeping the late game more or less secure. Do we have another Midas on Kaka? Nope, looks like he's just gonna be going. Just gonna be going into a phase drum Yasha, perhaps, or phase drum Deso. How doesn't a popping the Shadow Dance to secure that haste and deny it away from the Templar Assassin? But again, a really nice Fisher from Pretty Hog, gonna keep that locked out. And even Icy managing to pick up his Blink Dagger at this point as well. So those two early kills really paying off for him. Brewmaster still no opportunity to ult. He might actually be in a little bit of trouble. Ice Blast coming in down bottom lane. They've got the Doom on him as well. Ice Blast beautifully on three. Nuke comes out. Banana runs into the thick of things to try and slow this down, but it's not going to happen. Three dead immediately move. Looks like he's going to be next to fall. Does have 10 stick charges, but that's not going to keep him alive for all too long. Drops the Forge Spear. Tries to do what he can, but a four-man wipe from HGT. Beautiful chaining of abilities. Fisher, perfect. Right into the Doom on the Brewmaster from the run-up of ZSMJ. And no response whatsoever out of Newbie. The tower is Radiant's even in deny range. That was picture perfect. Dota, absolutely 100%. And even another TP threatened by Howe. Rabbit coming in, wants to use the split, drops it down. Who can he find, however? Just going to be a meld out of the Templar Assassin. Stuck here for the time being. I hope the Invoker is bringing a little bit of anti-invis. Is he? They've managed to get a Cyclone off as well. Invoker comes in, he's got the dust. They've isolated Kaka, ZSMJ re-engaging, but very, very low on mana, gets snapped up. In comes a Fisher and an Ice Blast, covering their retreat a little bit, Icy. Nothing left in the tank either, and Rabbit still going in. Doesn't have enough for a clap, but still gets the guaranteed crit. Sunstrike on Icy as well, not gonna land, not even needed. And HGT do end up losing two after all is said and done. Their tower deny still secured. Sunshine doing some split pushing off on top lane. Does manage to grab the top tier one with his Mass Serpent wards as all the kerfuffle was happening down bottom lane. So Newbie not really okay. Newbie, the four for nothing was absolutely disastrous. They managed to recover it a little bit, but still definitely in favor of HGT. Overall, though, as I say that, we check in on the graphs. Gold swinging back to about zero after a 3k lead in favor of Hyper Glory team, and experience about the same story, though, swinging back to about 1k from also a 3k deficit. Howe, meanwhile, just going to be picking up himself a drum. Looks like Mu is still going to be hammering in towards his Hand of Midas, though it is going to be a bit more of a recovery Midas than he would perhaps like. Rabbit, well, Blink Dagger in hand, as we saw, just going to be picking up a wand, maybe some treads or some phase boots. Begin working in towards... BKB is okay this game, but not that amazing, so maybe we'll just see an Aghanim Scepter and some auras out of him this game. And HET looking for another smoke, looking for another Doom, looking Radiant's for another pickoff. Forge Spirits attack. Are going to wander by, giving them an idea that Mu is still down here on this bottom lane, and they're moving into position, even going to cover the back path, even going to cover the forward path with an Observer Ward, and now on the hunt, they spot the Courier, they know that Mu has to be in here, here comes the Blink, Mu, what can he do? Drops the Sunstrike, not going to happen, in comes the Ice Blast as well, Mu should just tick out here, and can everybody on HGT get out without losing anybody? No response out of Newbie whatsoever, actually. Rabbit's just pinging at this tier 1 mid, he wants the trade. He's going to drag everybody back over there, but Howe was already kind of drifting towards bottom lane, so maybe some dissent in the ranks among Newbie and showing that the new leadership is costing them a little bit. Fisher goes out, there's an immediate Doom onto Howe. Can they close the gap here? Rabbit comes in, he's got the split, they've got the lockdown for the Templar Assassin. Should be able to close this one out. They do get the kill. Echo Slam gets dropped as well, Pretty Haw. Back down to Earth, not going to have enough for a Fisher here, so it looks like he will also be brought down. And Newbie finding the turnaround. They even managed to cycle in the Ancient Apparition. Rabbit lining up a clap. Sunstrike going to be coming in as well. Nicely timed. And a double kill out of the Brewmaster. Howe with the aggressive jump onto the high ground. He wants this tower kill. Is it SMJ looking for the deny? Does end up grabbing it. Howe needs to be careful as he goes back out through the Firefly. But they get the snap out onto Icy. Nice pounce as well on the very edge of the distance, and that's going to be one more kill for Newbie, and a much-needed kill going to Mu there on Invoker. So, Newbie taking stock of that fight, lose nobody, finds four kills, And they get a tower. So giving as good as they got down on bottom lane, and Sancheng getting chased down here by ZSMJ. Just gonna throw out a nuke. Is this ice blast gonna connect? Looks like it's Sancheng. Greedy. Turns around for the zap. Will be brought down. Probably would have died anyway, but we can frame it as a tiny bit of greed out of your four position support player here, who is actually doing very, very well on his overall net worth. Though again, props to the Lich, who is buying everything for the team right now. And meanwhile, HCT looking to head into Roshan, take advantage of that TA aspect of the lineup, but they are being spotted out by a nicely placed Radiant Observer Ward. Another Observer Ward over on the high ground, also providing some valuable intel for newbie as they make their way over to the pit. Rabbit, a little bit further away, is making his way over. It does have his point boost already picked up, so looks like it is going to be an Aghanim Scepter out of him. And Icy getting pretty close to his 4th staff as well, so we'll be keeping an eye on that one as things continue. But looks like HCT, realizing that newbie are moving over to their position pretty quickly, are gonna just back themselves out. And Slark, with that passive, reveals the fact that there's a ward here. They drop a sentry right on top of it. And now HUT have no vision over the pit, and no vision in general. This is pretty much the most frustrating thing about playing against a Slark on a coordinated team, that you are just never, ever going to have a single ward on the map. Slark is pinging out wards constantly, letting his team know where there's vision, and the Lich can quite easily buy sentries for days, so not going to be too much of a problem. Doom, he's been doing pretty well for himself so far this game, but some pretty heavy weight onto the SMJ's shoulders. There's still quite a bit of catching up the Templar Assassin needs to do. 2-for-3, okay score at this point in the game, but if you're HGT, you definitely want your TA to be snowballing a little bit more, if at all possible. And they are making quite a bit of space for her to just pick up farm while the rest of the team moves as a four-man unit. They're looking for Hao over on mid lane. They are going to just drop the Fissure to prevent the Dark Pact coming out. Drop the Doom. Don't end up using the Lasso, however, so looks like they will be able to just maybe smoke up again and pick up another kill. Do they have any smokes remaining? One smoke in stock, no smokes in inventories, and no smokes on the courier. So actually just one smoke gank remaining for HUT, at least for about the next 10 minutes, which is definitely relevant, just definitely worth keeping in mind, especially given their position on the map. They don't have a whole lot of vision, and newbie have a lot, so smoke ganks are even more valuable than they normally are. And their hero composition as well is very, very good for finding the smoke ganks. Like we saw, Fissure, straight out of smoke, into a Doom, into a Lasso. No chance for the opposing hero to react. And some pretty straightforward kills. And a jump in already from Icy, but this is what we were talking about. Trying to jump into the five-man lineup. They do manage to bring down the Lich, but ZSMJ hexed up, getting shackled now as well. Beautiful ward trap, but he's still got the phase boot, so it looks like he is going to be able to get out a little bit further. Not far enough to get back to safety, however, and Kaka also goes in hard against the Mass Serpent wards, but Refraction gets chewed up immediately. 3-for-1 so far in favor of Luffy. Pretty Hog going to drop the Echo Slam, looking for the kill on Hao, but retaking back up. He's going to be okay. Rabbit whiffing the clap a little bit, still going to be chasing forward, looking for this kill. Drops the Haze, Hao comes in. Sunstrike not even going to be needed. And newbie taking another 4-for-1. Also going to be looking towards this tier 1 tower after all is said and done. So just a beautiful team fight and a very questionable initiation out of Icy. He thought he saw an opportunity. His team was a little bit too far away. The rest of newbie reacted perfectly. And that was the catalyst that set off all of the events that we saw in that fight. And newbie just going to be committing to bring down this tower. TA going to be TPing on in, but not able to get the deny, not able to clean anything else up. So looks like that's going to be that. And interestingly enough, also going to be just a straight, probably a straight BKB rush out of the TA this game. I know that I mentioned Yasha a little bit earlier, but it looks like the call is going to be straight BKB. It's super important against Shadow Shaman, Invoker, Brewmaster, even Lich. Slark is the only one who you're maybe not as effective against, but even then, Pounce and Dark Pact are both very annoying to deal with this Templar Assassin. So I think this BKB choice is 100% necessary out of Kaka, and I probably should have pointed out that the BKB was the logical choice a little bit earlier. Anyway, checking in on our overall status, we are about 2k gold in front for newbie right now, about 4k experience. Looking in on items, Rabbit is getting himself awfully close to his Aghanim Scepter, so getting that, well, basically only getting the extra Thunderclaps online, doesn't really have the levels for all that much Drunken Haze or Drunken Brawler. And this is sometimes why we did see some Western Brewmasters when they were snowballing really hard after their Blink Dagger, going back for a Hand of Midas just to secure some fast levels. Gonna be a Lasso going out top lane, nicely timed in amongst the Dark Pact along with the Doom as well. Should be able to pick up this kill nice and easy with the Ice Blast as well. And there you go, HCT pushing their nose just a little bit out in front when it comes to kills. 13-12 the overall score right now, and the Blink Dagger also going to be picked up by the Doom this game. So ZSMJ not going super carry oriented. Looks like we might be seeing something like Blink Shiva's refresher, maybe Blink Shiva's BKB refresher, something along those lines. You're sort of middle of the ground between all utility Doom, say Arcane Boots, Mech, Shiva's refresher, and your right click Doom, which is, you know, much more drum, AC, BKB, etc., etc. And it's a build that we've seen a million times. Interestingly enough, ZSMJ just sitting on Speed Aura at the moment. Maybe we'll see him opt for a Centaur or an Alpha Wolf now that he's picked up his Blink Dagger and his team should be able to close the gap, but maybe he still wants the Speed Aura to help out his Batrider and help out his TA's positioning. Illusion. Oh, I didn't finish checking in on items, so it looks like Hao is probably working towards a BKB. We've got 2150 up on San Chung, so getting very close to a 4-staff, or he can snag a Blink Dagger right this second if you would like it. Banana, still not a heck of a lot of farm over on this guy, and still no mech, notably, for a newbie. And Mu, Necro 2 up, looking much healthier than his 0-2 start at the beginning of the game would have suggested, so things looking pretty good. Meanwhile, over on HGT, we've got Icy with a 4-staff, also working on a BKB of his own. S just working on a 4-staff as well. And that pretty much wraps it up for items on both sides. For anybody wondering about Earthshaker's Blink Dagger status, he is still a long, long way away. Hasn't really been surviving through the teamfights, and as a result, hasn't really been... Well, HGT haven't won a teamfight in a little while. The reason that they're up on kills is because of pickoffs for the most part, so... If you're not winning team fights, your Earthshaker's not really going to be getting all that much this game. And HUT, bold move. Five-man smoke going out. They've got some pretty good vision around the Roshan pit. TA traps also scouting out which camps are being cleared so they know where everybody is. Icy jumps in, but he can't find anybody. And he immediately gets hexed up. There's a jump clap going out. Chain Frost absolutely destroying HGT. They do manage to bring down the Lich. ZSMJ trapped behind the Fissure in amongst the Pandas. He's going to be brought down. Nice pounce as well out of Hao. S going to attempt the TP out, but that's not going to happen. Courtesy of a boulder from the Brulings, and what was looking like a very promising engagement from HGT goes completely out of the window, and now newbie can head into the pit with Mass Circle Wards ready to go. Clean up this Roshan. Easy peasy, no problems whatsoever. Pretty Haw, he's considering going over to poke his nose in there, but there's creeps watching him, and he's just going to immediately get jumped.
Roshan has fallen.
Sancheng even hiding up on the cliff waiting for him right now. So Aegis gets passed over onto Hao, who has been dying quite a bit, but he can buy his BKBs, so I don't know. Maybe they could have considered giving the Aegis over to the Invoker instead, who is now going to become priority number one, but Moon, knowing that, liable to play a little bit more defensively in these team fights as well. BKB complete for the Templar Assassin, so she might finally be able to start getting something done this game. Losing Roshan is actually a huge blow to HGT, because a big aspect of the TA pick was securing Roshan and taking that advantage as much as they possibly could, but now that newbie are actually the ones with Aegis in hand, this is where life can get pretty tough. And yeah, we've got BKB on the Slark. He can go as hard as he wants with BKB and Aegis. Primal split about 25 seconds away, so newbie do still have to be a little bit careful about what they do here. Same story for the Mass Serpent Wards, so I would be surprised if they went straight in, but they've managed to find out Pretty Haw over on the side. Sancheng with a nice jump in, cancels the TP. Not going to be able to escape. Mu, however, drifts a little bit too far into this fight. Can they burst down the Invoker to begin things? They will be able to. Hao going hard with the BKB, but the rest of the team has been forced away. The Firefly does end up killing the Necrobook, bringing down the Batrider, and Hao now trying to make his escape, but he will get chopped down. The rest of Newbie, considering the re-engage, Rabbit's low, he did end up being doomed, but can swap his treads. Swap your treads, buddy. No, okay, not happening. Just gonna jump straight in and clean up the big wave. Hex going out onto Kaka. He's already used his BKB. Ice Vortex buys some space, but it's not enough. The rest of HCT coming in. Chain Frost gets deployed, but only gonna get the one shot out of that one. S also trying to escape, but looks like he's gonna be okay. And Newbie, well, we'll just end up claiming, well, maybe claiming the prize of the 2-2 tower. They've got Master Put Wards and Primal Split. HCT don't really have anything left, so this might not be the best decision from HCT to try and engage. They do manage to bait out the split. Looks like Pretty Hot at the very least going to be going down for that one. Everybody else still kind of sticking around. And a nice Cyclone sending the TA up into the air. Still no BKB, gets hexed down immediately. But this MJ jumping back in. We've got a Sunstrike a little bit off the mark, but the TA looks like she's still done for. One more clap, one more crit finishes it off. And HCT forced to retreat. I don't know about the decision to leave the base there. The tower was still very healthy, and maybe they weren't keeping track of ultimates, but Brewmaster still had split, and Rasta still had wards, and they didn't have anything, so that was a bit of a questionable time to take an engagement, and Icy actually played pretty well in that last fight. He isolated Mu, dragged him under the tower, set up the initial engagement, so a slightly better performance out of the Batrider than we've been seeing in some of the earlier engagements, but Aegis also ended up being used, though I think overall, definitely a fight in Newbie's favor. 10k their experience lead, heading towards 7.5k the gold lead, and we are 26-26 into this game. Game 1 of a best of 3 for your upper bracket round 1 of the WEC LAN Finals here on Join Dota Blue. Vision continues to be a huge problem for HCT as their last couple of wards around the map are not long for life. This one likely to be dewarded, and well, this one just about to fade as well. Do we actually have some wards on right now? S is carrying, not a full pack, but we'll be able to establish maybe a tiny bit of protection over their jungle, though, well, Newbie are spying on them every which way right now. Just looking for those pickoffs to transition into some more Mass Serpent Ward towers. Meanwhile, just going to be your Ags into Auras as expected out of the Brewmaster, and oh, that's about it. Four staff also secured for Ancient Apparition over on HCT, but well, the net worth starting to paint a pretty grim picture. Doom doing pretty well for himself, but unless he's getting absolutely great value dooms out every fight and coordinating the initiation really well with the Batrider and the Earthshaker, then they're gonna have big problems. I mean, that was a big aspect of what happened in this top fight. He got the doom off on the Brewmaster, but Brewmaster just backed off all the way into this region and just waited out the doom. So the doom didn't pick up a kill, and that is 100% necessary for HCT to be winning these fights. 3.3k gold up on ZSMJ, so we'll be able to pick up his AC or his Shivas before too long. Meanwhile, Rabbit is now swapping his treads. Now that he has a Vlad and probably has all the mana that he could want, but no big deal. Mu trying to be a little bit showy is going to end up picking up a Blink Dagger. Does let him position himself much more defensively at the start of the fight, and then blink in with the Rasta or blink in after he sees the Batrider initiation. So it isn't the worst thing in the world, and he can do a lot from the back lines right now anyway. He can just send in Necrobook, he can send in Forge Spirits, he can drop a Sunstrike, and then all he needs to do is stay back safe and prepare himself for a good time to jump in with Deafening Blast, Cold Snap, and Ice Wall. So it's a bit of a showy build, but I think it's a solid choice here. We've got level 16 up on the Brewmaster as well, so rank 3 Primal Split ready and raring to go. Actually just going to end up being a BKB out of ZSMJ, deciding that he can't afford to farm up whatever the completion of this plate mail was going to be before Radiant's heading into top it. Newbie finding out an ancient stack, just going to be cleaning that one out pretty quickly, extending this golden experience lead even further, and well, maybe looking to head up onto the high ground before too long. We'll find out the Roshan respawn time in about 2 minutes, for anybody wondering about that. And otherwise, HCT just trying to scrape together whatever items they can. ZSMJ probably doesn't... He still wants to take a lot of farm, but They would still love to have, if they could, a Blink Dagger on this Earthshaker, damage item on this TA, any of the above, so. Let's see, what is Slark working towards? Okay, just gonna be a Scotty, it looks like, out of him. Ultimate Orb picked up, and, oh, Templar Assassin does get spotted, but not gonna be able to cancel that TP. And HUT probably need to be pushing up mid lane at the moment as well, but they looks like they figured out where Rabbit is. Can they cancel this TP in time? The blink from ZSMJ just there. The trap gets popped off. Sunstrike also coming in. Not going to do anything there, but with the Ice Blast, they do manage to slam home that kill. So. These TA traps over in some of these camps doing work for HUT, finding them another pickoff. How does round the corner, spots out the Doom, but not going to be able to do too much about him. He is, however, running straight into Sancheng and Banana. He might just be able to pop off his TKB, however, it needs to get out of these wards. Nice Shackle. Doing some good damage. They're going to drop the Chain Frost as well. Can the right clicks be enough to finish him? They will be able to. And Hao now coming in. BKB and Shadow Dance looking for Pretty Ha, who has a TP, but very unlikely to escape. Even investing the Echo Slam there. I think he knew that he was guaranteed dead, and Echo Slamming the Slark isn't going to do anything. He's just going to heal up off Shadow Dance in the next 2 seconds. It didn't do anything anyway because he was BKB, but yeah, that was a little bit of a questionable play. He's gonna be up in 20 seconds, but Echo Slam down for 2 minutes, so HUT, this could be a very difficult defense. They do have a Glyph available, no Doom for 30 seconds, but they may be able to hold until then. BKB up on the Batrider, so at least Radiant some semblance of good initiation, and I see very aggressive positioning, looking to get in from the side. Doesn't have his Blink Dagger right now, so just gonna force staff in. What is he doing right now? Just trying to cover the retreat as much as possible. They come in with a Templar Assassin. They've blown up one. Shadow Shaman down. Nice lasso onto the Invoker as well. Leads into a second kill. Looks like Banana also gonna fall. And HGT, well, realizing that Rabbit was actually all the way down at bottom lane and taking full advantage of that. I was thinking to myself, what is Icy doing? The Doom isn't alive yet. You've just used your Blink Dagger, so you can't blink in and force staff out, but all he was looking to do was interrupt the retreat as much as possible and punish Newbie for having Rabbit split off to the side. Is under attack. Well, nicely done, looking to this tier 1, buyback out of Sunshine, but can they actually get anything done here? Rabbit jumps in, but it's a nice Fisher. Can they get the chain stun down? Pretty Hard doing his absolute best, but it's not going to stop the Primal Split coming out. Now, where's the micro from Rabbit? Needs that Storm Aspect over to the side, lifts up the Templar Assassin, looks like everybody else okay for now. And TA just gonna try and hide here. Sancheng didn't bring any anti-invis after the buyback, so gonna have to wait around here for a little bit. Said SMJ, waiting down in the pit, considering going in. Sunstrike, clap. No chance to save the TA there. And both teams just seesawing back and forth. Small overcommitments on both sides. I see again, positioning himself off to the side, looking for this initiation. Who's he gonna jump? Maybe looking for Mu. Mu drifting himself further away in the fight, and Sancheng, he's found him. Can he get the Shackle off? Will be able to. Icy, completely isolated. Nice Ice Blast is gonna connect on two, but that is a huge pickoff for Newbie at this stage, and Batrider forced to buy back. Necrobook and the Mass Serpent wards up onto the high ground, making it very difficult for HUT to get in here. They buy themselves a few seconds with the Glyph. The SMJ on the front lines might be able to find an initiation. They're cleaning up the wards and the Necrobook as much as they possibly can, but Newbie not gonna stick around too long. Maybe a temporary back just to secure the Brewmaster split, and then maybe looking to head up onto the high ground. No, actually, Roshan's respawn. So that's going to be the call out of them. Good vision up on the cliff. HGT know full well that this is going on, so this is maybe their one opportunity for Icy to show off the power of that dire Batrider. He's making his way over. He's been spotted, and looks like Newbie going to reevaluate the decision and get the heck out of there. Top lane also not in a great position for them at the moment, but they can't really afford to TP anyone there for now, so maybe somebody will walk over and deal with it, but I doubt anybody's going to be TPing there, because that would kind of be a green light for HUT to go into Roshan. Do they have their Desolator up in the TA? They do, so this Roshan's not going to take too long, especially with the Pack Leader's Aura over on the Doom as well. The smoke has not been spotted by the wards or by the Forge Spirits. A little bit of fortunate timing, though there was some body blocking by the Ancient Apparitions, so maybe suspicions from newbie raised just a little bit. So they're staying grouped up as a unit, not going to risk a pickoff. Top lane is pushing out by itself, but HCT moving over to position. Have they got the vision? Have they got the initiation? Icy jumps in. He's getting the sticky down on everybody. They're dropping as much as they can on Rabbit. They will be able to first him down before the primal split, but he's got buyback available. They also finished off the Shadow Shaman. No buyback for him this time around. ZSMJ in the 1v1 against Tau. Not going to work out. Rabbit coming in, isolating Kaka. Is just going to use the primal split, it seems, for the one kill. Can he get the storm aspect off to the side to find somebody else? He's looking for S. Can he get the lift? Will be able to cancel the TP just in time, but Mu was ready with the snap anyway. Three kills picked up for newbie. Did cost them a buyback on the Brewmaster, but well worth it at this stage of the game. Icy needs to be careful what he does here. There is a double damage over on the Brewmaster. Nice blink away. Space created by Pretty Hot, but he's going to be the one to fall. Move blinking forward with that still invoked Cold Snap Banana. Through the fire and the flames, up onto the high ground. Just to help secure that. Just to secure the racks. Even got the last hit on that one, in fact. So we've got a very happy Lich in our midst. And newbie not done. They know that they've got the Mass Serpent Wards moving into position. Sansheng coming down the middle lane, and HCT still only the one hero alive. Icy, considering this initiation, once the Doom is back up along with the Ancient Apparition, they'd be looking for this Ice Blast. It's coming in, lined up on three. They're gonna jump on top of Hau. They do manage to burst down one ZSMJ. Jumps into the thick of this, but the Mass Serpent Wards drop back on the racks. Is that gonna be enough of a deterrent? Looks like it is. HCT get distracted by the Mass Serpent Wards, and they let Sansheng go free. They did, however, manage to pick up the ranged racks and some pretty substantial damage on the melee barracks as well. So, newbie now well and truly cementing this lead. And with Primal Split coming up in just a few seconds' time, they're going to look to keep on going. Dire Courier making its way out, trying to complete this Shiva's Guard. It's going to be finished off. It will. And in comes the Primal Split. ZSMJ not able to do anything. A beautiful Deafening Blast. Knocking back to Pretty Hall, wishing that he had that Echo Slime available. The Force Staff tries to get him up onto the high ground. A second Force Staff as well, but it's just not going to happen. And some really nice micro out of Rabbit. Keeps the TA isolated. Can they go in even further is the question, but looks like the call has been made after Mu TP's himself back to safety just to back off and head in towards Roshan. Man, this is pretty good out of newbie. The early game was super shaky, but the mid game they've really pulled it together. Banana has picked himself up a gem, so if HET weren't having enough map control problems against the Slark, it's only going to get worse. They do spot the Ice Blast coming in because of all of these wards towards the fountain and the pit, so just going to be backing themselves out as that one comes in, and maybe looking for a pickoff then. Heading in even further. 2.6k gold Dire's up on Hau. Would not be attack. Too surprised to see a Butterfly or something like a Basher over on him pretty soon. And S, not paying enough attention. Looks like he's just going to be brought down for the solo kill here. Four staffs away. Do manage to keep him safe. Nicely played. Hau, however, attack. Still elusive. Pops the BKB. Can they actually do anything about him? In the meantime, Roshan being brought down. Ice Blast coming in as well. Pretty hot. Keeping his eye on that BKB duration. Tornado tries to buy some space, but not going to happen. And a BKB out of Kaka sends Sancheng running. He's not going to be able to do anything this fight. Roshan has fallen. Not picked up by anybody just yet. Echo Slam gets dropped on the edge of the pit. ZSMJ jumps it. Does he have space for it? He did, but not going to be able to grab it. Rabbit gets doomed, but it doesn't matter. He secured that Aegis. He's going to fight on. Mu comes in. Nice combo drop. Brings down Pretty Hot. No more BKB for the Templar Assassin. No more safety. Gets snapped up. Banana just standing there saying hello in his Ghost Scepter. Making sure that he gets that gold and experience from the kill, but double kill for Mu, styling all over this game after the frankly shocking start that he had. And that is going to be the GG out of ZSMJ, and we are going to be heading ourselves into game 2. Thank you very much, guys, for tuning in here for WEC LAN Finals. This is your upper bracket, and this was game 1, one of our round 1 matches between HGT and newbie. I'm Basekip here providing coverage on behalf of Join Dota. If you want to leave me any feedback, you can email me at basekipdota@gmail.com. Don't forget to check out Join Dota Red, where EG versus Vici Gaming is, I believe, ongoing. I think they may have already started game 2. For anybody wanting to go and check that one out, that is Toby and Clairvoyant over on Join Dota Red. For those of you sticking with me, thank you very much, and we'll be back with Game 2 coming up shortly. See you soon, guys.